doesn't look like a knockout artist, but she puts girls to sleep. Jelena, how do I pronounce your last name right?
Mrdjenovich.
Mrdjenovich.
You got it.
Close enough. You're a Canadian. You're a champion. You've been boxing. You're 50th fight already. You passed it?
50th fight, so this will be my 51st fight in June.
What's your record now?
Actually, to be honest with you, I don't know.
I know you have a lot of knockouts, though.
Yeah. Yeah, I think I win. I'm at 66% knockout ratio of my wins.
What was it like to be here tonight at the WBC event, Hubla, raising money to charity to help fighters?
Listen, the WBC always puts on an amazing event. And so now what they partnered up with Hubla, and they're doing this phenomenal thing for Retired Boxers Foundation in honor of Jose Suleiman. You can't ask for a classier event.
Now, you have a fight coming up. Tell everybody. June 22nd?
June 22nd, yes.
Who are you fighting? Do you know?
Vissa, I'm going to murder her name, but Vissa Travado.
Okay.
Out of Italy.
And where's finally, the fight? Is it back home?
It's in Edmonton, yes.
Good. You're going to sell out?
Bye.
You know Julio's wife?
Bye.
Bye. Good seeing you. I'm going to come visit you guys in Tijuana very soon. Julio's in camp, no?
Yeah, she's going to stay there about an MMA.
Oh, okay. Well, I'll go visit him. Have a good night.
Okay.
Nonito looks like an action hero, some kind of movie, Transporter 5.
I feel like we need to do like a Marvel like, type thing. Like,
yeah, you totally Wonder
Woman. I got it.
Are you guys going to Hakkasan?
That right?
I got a text message. Nonito's in Hakkasan. I'm like, how can he be in Hakkasan?
But I have.
Wait, so you're leaving?
There's no way. I'm not going to Hakkasan.
You're not going to Hakkasan?
No.
But he might go.
He might. You know, mom always has to go home early.
That's
mom has
true.
Cinderella curfew.
Somebody has to take care of the baby.
Right? And it's asking me. They don't want a picture of me on it.
Nonito. Nonito Donel. So, Jelena, where do people follow you if they're watching this video?
At Jelena Boxing.
Jelena Boxing?
Yeah.
Spell it out.
J-E-L-E-N-A Boxing.
And there are a lot of stars here tonight. Who are some of your favorites from the legends?
Oh, my goodness. Roberto Duran, my all-time favorite. Julio Cesar Chavez, Jeff Fennec. You have Lennox Lewis. You have the who's who of boxing in this room right here. So, I mean, if you weren't here, you want to be here. And maybe next.
By the way, have you ever met Claressa Shield?
Claressa is amazing.
Claressa, have you ever met Jelena? She has over 51 pro fights. What can you tell me about her?
Well, she fights at 126. I found it out today. I thought she was bigger.
Yeah. She's tall?
Yeah, she is tall.
The shoes. Oh, man.
But
then also, too, she walks around probably at her weight. Like, to be 126, I get pretty big to fight 160. She's about, like, a buck 30 right now.
So I'm a veteran in this sport, so I'm 36 currently. So I've...
Girl, look at how young she looks. Look at this.
So,
look, you can't buy that.
We're a veteran coming to the new age of boxing, and she's going to carry the sport.
You know what's that about her success? Yeah. Two gold medals,
amazing.
Multiple belts. Amazing. Nobody thought she could win, and she destroys.
I don't know if nobody thought she could win.
Hello.
I think
you, because you know boxing. I'm just going off what I see online.
100%.
Am I wrong?
I mean, this is the difference. This is where now the women of past boxing and the ones who built the sport were able to make it so women could be in the amateurs in the Olympics.
Yeah.
And now this is the future now. So it's kind of all becoming full circle where now I have a hard time feeling myself as a pioneer in the sport, but I've been around for eons. And this is the future of women's boxing. I would love to be a part of the future, but let's be honest, I'm turning 37 soon, and this is where the sport is going. So to see someone as amazing as Claressa take the torch and carry it on and do phenomenal things and represent the sport in a classy way is humbling.
Did you
so
know
it's amazing.
Her opponent last fight, you know what's in her mouthpiece?
I saw that.
You know, but you know what? It's a time to be classy, and it's a time to talk trash. And it's a time to be humble and embrace your opponent. And I think I did everything right for my last fight, even though a lot of the women before me, say I talk too much and I better back it up and that's not classy. People have to realize, women, we have to sell our fights. Nobody wants to see me and him fight if we're at the weigh-ins and we're kissing and hugging each other saying I love you.
You're right.
You know, but I did have a lot of love for him. And like, you know, deep down inside, it was like, I did love her competitiveness. I love that she was undefeated for 9 years. I love that she took the challenge against me knowing that I'm a badass bitch.
That's true.
And she was like, I'm a badass woman and I want to fight her.
That's so amazing.
I love that she stepped up and that we made that fight happen, because in women's boxing, it's only one other woman who's undisputed, and that's Cecilia Brockman. So to have it at the middleweight division was great.
So there you have it. Another great video for ES News. For ESNewsReporting.com, I'm Elie Seckbach reporting, and you can follow me on Twitter at Seckbach, and you can follow me on Instagram at Elie Seckbach.